everyone. Welcome to Magic TV. I'm Tristan Shaun Gregson here with Luis Scott-Vargas. We're bringing you the top eight of the week, and we know you wanted more blue, but we're going to bring you the next best color in Magic.
Black, obviously. Okay. I mean, there are requests for the 9 through 16 blue cards, because we did blue definitely has some depth there.
We might be back to that later.
We will. But we're going to start with black. We're going to start with number 8 here, a card which is currently legal in Standard, even.
Excellent. Duress.
Yep. Duress is first print in Saga. Was pretty awesome there. I like the original art the best, despite the fact that the guy's hand is like overly enlarged if you look at the perspective of the original art.
He's got a little gigantism. It's fine.
Yeah, the card's awesome. I mean, before Thoughtseize, there was Duress, and Duress was the card that kind of revolutionized hand disruption. Like,
I think a great example is, was there any time it was in Standard that it wasn't being played?
No. And there's been no time since its printing that it has not seen significant play in Vintage. Even now, even with Thoughtseize, you still see decks that play 4 Duress and 1 to 2 Thoughtseize, because they're playing Necro in their deck and whatnot. So yeah, Duress is, I mean, and also Duress, another like good part about it, it's never actually broken. It's always good, but it's never broken. It's a 1-for-1 at best. It's never more than a 1-for-1. And it's, you're spending a mana, they're spending 0 mana. So the fact that you get like, you know, precision, you get to take their best card that you can take, is good, but it's not the kind of card that people complain about, whereas like Hymn to Turok is the kind of card it's very annoying to get cast.
Yeah, Duress is, it seems so fair, it seems so perfectly designed. I mean, there's plenty of times where I'm playing a creature-based deck in game one, my opponent goes Swamp Duress, they whiff.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, you have 5 cards now, and I'm about to go
perfect.
To 8.
So, yeah, I think Duress easily makes it on the list, both in terms of overall playability and just the fact that it's a good card. So, next up, we've got a card which is no longer in Type 2, though it was there for a long time, Dark Ritual.
Yeah, so many printings of this card, it seemed like it was just fair enough to be in Standard forever.
Then it turns out it wasn't.
No.
As it turns out, the original Alpha Boons didn't work out quite like they thought. Healing Salve, never good. Giant Growth, saw some play, reprinted a lot, still not great. Then the other three were Lightning Bolt, and Dark Ritual, and Ancestral Recall. So the best blue card, a card which is on the black top 8 list, and a red card which is going to be on the red top 8 list.
I would imagine. Somewhere on there, yeah.
Dark Ritual, casting many of the other cards on this list with great abandon.
Fast mana. It's always been the key in Magic. It's too good, and this one is...
Yeah, I mean, there are things you can Dark Ritual out which aren't a big deal, but the fact is those never get Ritualed out. You know, Ritual Dark Juzam Jin is awesome, but... Yeah, that's acceptable.
Sacred Vampire, Single for Hypnotic Spectre. These are all things I've seen many times.
Ritual, Duress, Dark Confidant, Ritual, Necro. Yeah, those things probably should not be allowed.
Ritual, Rain of Tears you. These
no,
are things.
No, that's acceptable. What, are we playing your cube now?
Shut up. And no.
So, next up, you know, it beat out Duress, but it's not like incredibly much better. Thoughtseize. It's much, much better in the newer formats. In the older formats, Duress still actually, you know, spells are just so good in old formats. But in new formats, yeah, it's not even close. Thoughtseize is infinitely better.
Extended, Standard, every time it was legal in that format.
It was played as a 4-of in, like, many decks.
Yeah, I mean, $25 out of the gate, this card was a big deal. I think it's great for the color black that this card's only number 6.
Yeah,
well, here I mean, it's
again, black is got a color with a lot of good cards, which isn't surprising. But, you know, it was always blue as a partner in crime, so...
I just like the Duress Thoughtseize combination is always kind of for the black mage, it's always the clear the way through the blue player, especially in Vintage. It's like, can I do my things now? Can I get myself?
Yeah, I mean, if you look at Thoughtseize is a great combo enabler. Like, it's seen play in, like, you know, Tendrils decks to clear the path for the combo. It's also a great card to fight against combo with. And much like Duress, it does not feel broken. I mean, it's good, but it doesn't feel broken. Though when they go Thoughtseize, Bitter Blossom, and Extended, that feels pretty filthy.
Yeah, but that's more Bitter Blossom's fault than Thoughtseize's fault.
True. So. Number 5, we've got the Dark Confidant himself, the Invitational card.
It seems like every time we do a list that
he's on it,
capable of being on, he's there.
Well, that's because he's insane. And the fact that he's number 5 is pretty good, because Black's got some nice restricted cards coming up. We'll just say that.
Yeah.
We've talked at length about Dark Confidant, so I guess we don't really need to go too much more into it. But suffice to say that Dark Confidant, you know, the best 2-drop ever printed, probably the best creature ever printed, and pretty much just a ridiculous card overall.
Yeah, now let's talk about some tutoring.
Yeah, all right. So the next two are actually tutors, and we had some disagreement with the Ocho especially about which order. We've got Vampiric Tutor up now, which he thought had more impact than the next card overall, but I think is a worse card, which is why it's number 4 instead of number 3.
I think there's arguments for both, and I think that it's so great that Black has options to have both, and there's diversity in it.
Vampiric Tutor powered one of the first Tier 1 combo decks in the history, Prosbloom. Mike Long used to Vampiric Tutor a lot, even when he didn't have Vampiric Tutor, apparently. But
can neither confirm nor deny.
Yeah, actually, that's not, I don't even know. But I mean, when you end up with cadavers bloom on your lap, that's kind of.
So usually it puts the card at the top of your library for two life, instant speed, only a black mana. I don't know how this is fair.
I have played this card in fair decks, though. I played this card in rock decks, much like when you talked about the deck I played at GP Anaheim. Vampiric Tutoring for Oktavi Orangutan or Pernicious Deed or Ravenous Bailoff, that's not too broken. It really isn't.
pretty fair.
But the fact that Vampiric Tutor was in that format is pretty absurd. So, yeah, Vampiric Tutor does a lot of things, and usually your opponents aren't going to be very happy when it happens.
Yeah, only less excited is when you're in Vintage and your opponent casts Demonic Tutor, and then they get to resolve it.
Right, and that's, of course, the next card, Demonic Tutor.
That is number three right there.
I mean, I've had my beta Demonic Tutor for probably like 10 years now, and I'm quite attached to it. It's gotten me a lot of good cards. A lot of Black Lotuses and Ancestral Recalls.
I've had to go through many of them in my day because people keep selling mine.
Yeah, well, I'm too lazy to sell cards. So, but yes, Demonic Tutor, I mean, it was originally printed in Alpha. It was what passed for a fair card back then.
It made it all the way to Revised. You got to think that ability didn't seem too
absurd. I mean, back then people weren't Demonic Tutoring for Necro. They were Demonic Tutoring for Serra Angel or Sengir Vampire. And
Fire Elemental, Water Elemental, the
big guys. I've Demonic Tutored for Sengir Vampire before. It's quite a powerful play.
Did we do that in ME4 draft not too long ago?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I meant back when, like, in Revised.
I understand. Little Luis.
Yes. But, Demonic Tutor is a pretty sweet card. It's really only shows up in Vintage, like, control or combo decks. But, like, the Vintage, even, like, the aggro-ish type decks can't really afford to play it as much. But it's still a pretty awesome card.
In many ways, cards 3 and 4 on this list are some of the reasons you want to play Black in Vintage.
Yeah, you're gonna play 1 and 2. So number two, which is I think the number of times I've cast this and not won are very, very, very low. I'd say like under 10%. So that'd be a Yawgmoth's Will. I mean, when you cast this in Vintage, actually the wills I like the best, the ones that are the most fun, are the ones for value. The one where you go Yawgmoth's Will, replay Polluted Delta, cast Brainstorm, play Mox Emerald, like, you know, or cast Time Walk. Like, you're not going to directly win the game off these, but you actually get to keep playing and you just, you know, drew three or four cards, got an extra land drop. Those are awesome. The Yawgmoth's Will is where your opponent just, you know, looks at you, go, can I look at your graveyard? Pick it up, give it back to you, pick up their cards. Those are less fun. I mean, you obviously win the game, but it's a lot less fun than the ones where they think they have a chance but really don't.
Yeah, I mean, I feel the same way. There's nothing more satisfying than going crack my Lotus, you know, whatever.
Yeah, Use Vampiric. So look at all these black cards. Thought Sees You, Vampiric Tutor for Lotus, Yawgmoth's Will, you know, recast Vampiric Tutor, Brainstorm, cast Tendrils or whatever. Yawgmoth's Will, all Dark Ritual helps in there, and that sequence of plays as well.
Yeah, most of the cards on this list are actually, outside of like Dark Confidant, which usually enables the big Yawgmoth's Will, all these cards could be played with it.
So actually the number one card is actually currently legal in Standard here, so. Well, have you heard this before? Can I keep going?
Yeah. This is your baby.
Yeah, well, I think the best black card of all time right now is, of course, Gruesome Encore.
Obviously. I mean, there's no other way to get your opponent's Dark Confidants out of their graveyard and play on your side. I'm already losing it. I can't.
Have you ever Demonic Tutored for one of these? It's pretty awesome. Actually, the best is Vampiric Tutoring them to the top of your opponent's deck, so then they draw them. But in any case, the actual best card...
For those of you that haven't guessed already, we've been fumbling around.
You know, the Skull, Necropotence. The card that, when I first read the card, did not think it was good at all. Granted, you know, I'd been playing Magic for a year at this point, and this is back in, I would say, the Stone Age, the Ice Age of Magic. But no one really knew what was going on.
Skip your draw phase. Yeah. Seemed like a big deal.
Why would you skip
then?
Your draw phase? That's horrible.
Like, playing the game and just being like, oh, can't really do anything. Your turn.
Yeah, so let's just say we didn't really know what was going on. Then people started putting it in decks, and then they started putting four of them in decks. Then they started playing Demonic Consultation in decks. Turns out Necro is actually just absurdly broken. Life for cards is not a fair deal when it's a 1-for-1 and 0 mana.
Comboed with Zurin or, I mean...
Ivory Tower, Drain Life.
Turn one off Ritual. Like, there's...
I've played a fair amount of games with Tendrils decks in Vintage at this point. And by fair amount, I would be surprised if it wasn't near 1,000. I don't know. But Necro is the card I most often win with, I think. Like, I think between Demonic Tutor, Vampiric Tutor, and just, you know, Ponder and stuff, being able to find and play Necro on turn 1 through 3 is what leads to the most wins in the entire deck. And because you've got Dark Ritual and Cabal Ritual and Lotus to cast it early, and then you've got Force of Will to protect it, and playing Necro, Necron for like 10, and then forcing their play that you found off the Necro is insane. So Necro's just absurd.
I think it really speaks to the card that not only was there the Black Summer when it was in every standard deck ever, but then flash forward to the current age where you can play it in Vintage and it's just as much of a
powerhouse. Beating. Like, I mean, Vintage has a lot of powerful stuff going on, so it's not like I'm even saying Tendrils is the best deck, but every Tendrils deck plays Necro in it. So even the Ad Nauseam deck that just tries to go off on turn two with Ad Nauseam still has a Necro in the deck because, you know, Land Ritual Necro, you can mold a two. You can mold a Lotus Necro, and I think you're favored to win that game if they don't have Force of Will. Like, heavily favored.
Yeah.
So.
Huh, Jace or Necro? I guess you still want Necro.
Yeah.
Okay.
Necro
okay.
will still beat Jace.
Just checking.
As ridiculous as Jace is, Necro still gets him.
Because I'll never forget when Zach Preston lost to a Mold of Three.
I do remember this. His opponent, Mold of Three, Zach duressed him on turn one. And the guy's hand was Jace, a land, and a Mox. And the guy Zach took the Mox because the guy has all two drops in Zach. You know, it was an aggro deck even. And the guy drew Lotus, goes land Lotus Jace, and wins the game.
So I used to think, I was like, well, that seems pretty unbeatable. But if you're like, nope, didn't get there, nope, didn't get there, nope, didn't get there, Lotus Necro, that seems pretty darn good.
So Necro, pretty easily the number one, just because of, it's got everything. Like, historically, Yawgmoth's Will didn't dominate when it was, like, in Standard. It was, like, a card, but it wasn't, like, the card.
It was in a very good deck.
Yeah, but it wasn't, like, Yawgmoth's Will's
You were
fault.
Getting back, like, Ticking Gnomes and Ravenous Rats, and, like, it was a little bit different.
Yeah, whereas Necro dominated when it was first printed. They reprinted it for inexplicable reasons.
Fifth edition.
Yeah. Dominated it again, and is still very, very good in Type 1, whereas Yawgmoth's Will is also very good in Type 1, but I think Necro's better, and Necro was insane back then. So, yeah, it seems like a pretty solid top 8 list there.
Honorable mentions. We can throw out a few that we kicked around before. I mean, Mind Twist was something I wished had been on there, but
didn't quite make it. Yawgmoth's Bargain, you know, the bad Necro.
Yeah, the more expensive one. Hymn to Torak.
Those are definitely cards, but I think the ones we have are pretty solid. I mean, Imperial Seal is much, much worse than Vamp, but still an interesting card. Grim Tutor. Like, there's a lot of, like, Ad Nauseam is definitely a card that we mentioned or we talked about, but it still wasn't quite good enough just because I think, despite the fact that it's enabled all these wins, it's supported by so many of the cards on the list that without these cards, Ad Nauseam would be nothing. You know, Dark Ritual and Duress and Thoughtseize. And
I mean, in that same vein, you could say Tendrils of Agony as well. I mean,
right.
Tendrils of Agony, along with Mind's Desire, those two cards kind of, like, changed the way a Magic game could be played.
Yeah,
which
definitely.
I think was a big deal and was obviously powerful.
Yeah, you know, I've had good times with Mind's Desire. So.
We all know.
But, those are our top 8 black cards. If you'd like to see different colors, let us know which ones. We're going to go through them all at this point, but
I think we've decided, after a little debate of like, oh, I don't want to do green or white, or maybe we could lump them into the best green-white together cards, but we'll
figure it out, and we'll see if you have suggestions as to what we missed, because I'm sure maybe we missed something.
Sometimes we miss cards like Oven Pile Driver.
It happens.
That
was the TSG's fault.
I guess. I remember I was like thinking about red cards. All I could think of was Mog Flunkies.
But that's our top 8 of the week. Thanks for watching.
Can't get enough.
TSG's played that card quite a bit, actually.
It's been played on me a lot.
Yeah. It's one of his favorite cards.
Magic, he's going to go to a bar and I give a woman my number. Right on the back of one of these bad boys.
It's his business card.
Quiet on the set, please.
I just want to open a bar now.
Reaching through your head.